net play. I'm going to give the Howie.
Excited? Absolutely. So nice to see everybody, and certainly the children, the girls in their dresses, the boys in their suits and ties. I wonder how long the suits will stay on at the parties. And clean. Just a couple of thoughts and directives, so to speak, before we begin. For pictures, please take pictures afterwards, as opposed to during the ceremony. And then afterwards, when you get pictures, certainly you can go outside. It's a beautiful day, to the Blessed Mother Grotto, the St. Francis Grotto. Out front's beautiful. The inside of the church is beautiful. If your family gets together for a picture and you want to take your mask off, please take your mask off. Then afterwards, put it back on. Throughout this ceremony, I would ask everyone to please keep a mask on, a mask that would cover your face. And let me mention about Holy Communion. Holy Communion has worked great here. And for the children, we already practice, and some of the parents. But for some of you, I know for my mother's at her granddaughter's, I'm missing my niece's first communion at the same time. But it's my mom's first time back in church, so I realize that I might be a little anxious. For receiving communion, myself and Father McLaughlin, two ministers, we'll have our mask on. Just please wear your mask, and please receive on the hand also. After receiving communion, please distance about 6 feet. Then take your mask off and receive communion. So thanks so much. We're going to start in just a few minutes. How about we begin with a prayer? Today's May 1st. We'll reach out to the Blessed Mother Mary and ask God to bless our first communicants and yourselves. Let us pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and St. Madeline, please remain seated. The cantor is also going to read a few things at this time. Thanks so much.
Good morning, and welcome to the Mass of First Fruits 2021. At this time, we ask all those caring and celebrating, please transfer their function to the silent. A Mass has been provided for your participation. Please stand and join in our entrance. Let heaven rejoice.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
From Brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Prayers.
Please stand now for our prayers of the faithful. Heavenly Father, we present all of our prayers and petitions to you,
especially on behalf of your special children who will receive Jesus in your first Holy Communion today.
For the Church, as she welcomes our first communion candidates to the table of the Lord for the first time today, that she may always give us the sacrament of everlasting life, we pray to the Lord. For our nation, that we may all be mindful to share our bread with the hungry and poor in our midst, we pray to the Lord. For all those who have helped prepare our first Holy Communion candidates to encounter our risen Savior at this sacred banquet, especially their parents, guardians, and catechists, that He will bless them for their good work, we pray to the Lord. For children who are poor, hungry, homeless, or victims of war, that Jesus will protect them and fill them with His peace, we pray to the Lord. We pray annually in this first Holy Communion that Jesus will provide more priests and religious sisters to serve the Church. We pray to the Lord. For the sick, that Jesus, the divine physician, bring them healing and comfort in their illness. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of our first Holy Communion candidates, that Jesus will assure them the gift of eternal life, as He promises all those who receive Him and the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, your Son asks that the children be permitted to come to Him. As your loving children, we ask your help to recognize you always in the breaking of the bread through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Celebrating the memorial of our salvation, we humbly beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us a sign of unity and a bond of charity through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, with one voice, we acclaim.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, and all who proclaim your word. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the
let us pray with confidence in the words.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, but not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy. Body of Christ.
Thank you.
Please stay seated for just a moment. I'd like to offer a word of thanks, but I had a thought this morning. Over 20 years ago, I met a convert to the Catholic faith. He tried to teach me golf. He was a great golfer, not so much me. Anyway, his name was Mike Romance, and he had recently converted to Catholicism. And once in a while, he would ask me questions about the faith. I only remember one question that he asked me. He said, what do priests do after communion when they close their eyes, when they sit down and close their eyes? I said, well, that's a good question. I said, normally I pray. I try to maybe picture myself with Jesus. I just receive Jesus. And Jesus is always with us, but he's with us in a special way in communion. I said, I just pray and maybe pray for people. But in a special way, I really am amazed at your children. Some of the answers that they gave were great. So what do we pray about? We pray that Jesus helps us to be peaceful. Jesus helps us to feel blessed and grateful and joyful. So the parents, God bless you. To the children, congratulations on behalf of everyone. Let's offer our congratulations to all the children now. If mothers keep any pictures of their children, it's when they're born in their first communion. That's for sure. That's in my house. And a word of gratitude to everyone who assisted in making this such a great day here at St. Madeline's, especially to Mrs. Boyle, the Director of Religious Education. It's really a year-round type of commitment. To the catechists from the St. Madeline Prep Program, the teachers from St. James Regional Catholic School, who had the great opportunity and blessing to teach your children about the Catholic faith. To our musicians, to Sean and Brian, our servers, our live streamer, that's new in a pandemic, and our servers, and everyone to help decorate the church and get this ready. It's always great when you have a priest relative, at least some of my relatives tell me that. We have Father Dan McLaughlin here. He gave communion to his great niece, Rosemary Clavin. Congratulations. It's always a special moment. So to the children, I'll make one request. Please pray for me as I pray for you on this special day. To the families, I pray for you all the time, and please keep me and St. Madeline's in your prayers. Let us pray. May sharing at this heavenly table sanctify us, Lord, we pray, so that through the body and blood of Christ, the whole family of believers may be bound together in peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Enjoy your special Holy Communion day.